Somehow, with Matthew's death, all the softness that he found in me seems to have dried up and drained away. Maybe it was only ever there in his imagination.
I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears.
My husband is dead. After all he's suffered in the war, he's killed in a stupid car crash.
Your presence still lingers here, and it won't leave me alone. These wounds won't seem to heal.
Matthew is dead 50 years before his time.
This pain is just too real. There's just too much that time can
erase. Isn't that enough for me to deal with?
When you cry,
I would never be happy with anyone else as long as you walked the earth. And I think you feel the same about me.
Yesterday you said, I feel your brain. Well, Matthew feels mine, still. And I don't want to be without him. Not yet.
You used to captivate me by your resonating light. Now I'm bound.
And now I shall sign this and get off home for dinner with you.
Your face it haunts my once.
What a lovely, lovely thought.
Your voice it chased away all the sanity.
I will always love you.
This pain is just too real. There's just too much that time cannot erase. When you cried, I'd wipe away all of your tears.
I will love you.
When you scream,
until the last breath leaves my body.
Matthew loved you. He wanted you to be happy.
You have a straightforward choice before you. You must choose either death or life.
It's time for you to come back to us.
And you think I should choose life?
Sometimes I don't know whom I'm most in mourning for. Matthew or the person I used to be when I was with him.
I hope I'm allowed to be your Mary Crawley for all eternity.
My Mary always, because mine is the truth.